In my whole touring business, Canada I have missed. And I would request some of you to go to Canada, because it's a very beautiful place and we have very beautiful Sahaja Yogis there. You have to do now my work.
Lord Ganesha, please remove all of the obstacles to the Devi School students doing their very best on the exam today.
Jai Shri Mataji, I'm Mary. I have the great privilege and blessing to be the principal of the Devi School. And we're having lots of fun here, but I just tell you very, very briefly how it is that we could start. And that was with an enormous blessing that came from Shri Mataji. That was this school, the building where I'm sitting right now. We were able to have for $1, and that was from the municipality here where we live. And from there, we thought, okay, let's see around the world if there actually is a desire for a Sahaj middle school, high school. And we put out the word together with Tom and Nicola Locke in the UK. And what came back was a resounding yes. So this gave us really the confidence to start. We are very proud to welcome the students to this part of the world. And because it is Sri Krishna's land, there's a particular playfulness at the Devi School. And we find that one of our challenges, it's a happy one, but it is a daily one, is to manage this balance between that playfulness and the fact that it is a school. Because if we left the students to their own devices, they're very motivated, they're very intelligent, as these born realized souls are, very talented kids, and strong. They have a real depth. But they love each other so much, and they're really best friends. They can entertain themselves without any interference from teachers if we gave them the choice. But we do need to keep them stimulated in school, and using this Nova Scotia curriculum, Canadian curriculum, we feel it meets our needs, and we've been very satisfied with it. It is a blessing in Canada that we can be quite open, the fact that this is a Sahaj school, and that we follow our guru, and Shri Mataji's name is right out front on the sign here at the school. Our oldest students are now 16, going on 17. A couple of them are learning to drive actually here with us, which is a cause of great excitement among all the students. So far, so good with that. Some of them are looking into the possibility of even getting a part-time job here as an international student. So really for us is keeping track of this move and allowing something very important to us, allowing the students to have this space to grow and this freedom to actually grow up and to make that move with confidence and a sense of freedom, but also this support within a Sahaj environment from childhood into their teenage years, and to let them start exploring actually what it means to be a yogi or a yogini as a free-thinking and independent teenager. And in 3 short weeks, the kids will be going home, and I already don't know what I'm going to do when that happens, because I love them so much. And I encourage anyone who has questions about the school or about what we're trying to do here, the vision to actually grow a very solid, very strong middle school, high school, to please reach out. I can promise you that as your sister, we are trying our best to be very open, to be transparent in honoring and pleasing and worshiping Shri Mataji through this project, through loving and educating and supporting her children. Jai Shri Mataji.
It's a bit special week at the Devi School because we're in the middle of final exam, so we have to be just a little bit quiet.
All students are really active in music, I'd say, and if they weren't when they came, they are now, which is so great. The students have they have individual lessons in piano, violin, guitar. There's a clarinet teacher that comes in. He happens to live in the village here. So we have 3 classes of juniors, namely juniors, intermediates, and seniors. So the seniors are at the stage of 15, 16 years old. And so in England, that would be GCSE standard. So I'm teaching GCSE classroom music here for them. And of that standard, of people who know UK standards. And it's really, really nice to be able to, in the Canadian system, to choose our own curriculum. So we can choose the most fantastic music to study. So for our set works, we can choose Mozart, we're doing some Bach, and we're looking at the overall history of music, right from ancient Mesopotamia, and how it went through all the ancient civilizations up to the present day. So it's such a wonderful thing, after doing teaching in UK for myself for, let's say, many years, to now be able to choose the curriculum and have really great things in the curriculum for these children to study. Like, we can choose our ideal curriculum for them to study. It's all going, it's, the corridors are full of music sometimes. You'll see a clarinet up one end of the corridor and a guitar in the art room, and everyone's playing, and it's really, really nice to, it reminds me of when I was at music college myself, and you've got different instruments coming out of all the different rooms.
Linda St. John. Many of you will know me as Auntie Linda. I'm the one usually who responds to your emails, and it's my privilege to be here working at the school. I remember when the email came out advising us about the possibility of the school, that it was something for me that just leapt into my heart, and I knew that I had to be part of this. My whole life, my whole career, my working career has been in finance, in all forms, all different kinds of jobs over the years. And I've also had a very successful service business for about 18 years. So this, for me, working at the Devi School, is not a hardship. It's a passion. It is something which I can bring and I can add and I can help uplift all of the others, and we can all do this as a team. For me, this is an absolute pleasure, an absolute joy. And I look forward to every day when I can come into the office and I can be with the kids and I can help out making photocopies, you know, all the little things that the kids need, the staff needs. It's all truly a pleasure, and I love every minute of it.
My name is Aaron Rosenfall. I'm the head teacher at the Devi School. I teach mathematics and science and world religions at the school. We also had a once a week Sahaja Yoga class, but the opportunity in a world religions class is to go a little bit deeper into the world religions, of course, including a Sahaj perspective. So to look, what is the beauty in the religion? How are the religions connected to each other? In which ways and in which parts of history do they go, do they take a misstep? Do they go away from the beauty of the original teacher? A Sahaj school can be much more. Just as in many things in Sahaj Yoga, maybe we're just starting to reach the potential of the vision that Mother has given us. There are wonderful opportunities in every subject, whether it's mathematics or English or history or geography, to not only teach the subject, but to really go deep into it and to find ways to incorporate a Sahaj perspective.
Take your shoes.
Jesus.
Grab it,
that was a good shot.
Take your shoot. Rebound. Go, Sharon, shoot.
Jeremy, go, back. Yes.
Okay, good job, people.
1-0. It's ours. Ow.
Well, the philosophy I've employed at the Devi School is to produce food from all over the world. So that means food from India, food from Hungary. We have two of our dorm staff here from Hungary, so we have Hungarian dishes, we have Chinese dishes, we have American favorites, we have a lot of pasta from Italy. So it just runs the gamut from rice and dal to, today we're also having roast turkey with mashed potatoes and gravy, so it's the American classic. What do they like most? The butter chicken is a favorite. I made pizza yesterday. That is one of the all-time favorites of the kids. Mm-hmm.
Supposed to be.
So, I'm gonna fit through the door.
We might.
You got it, you got it.
Yeah.
Wait, wait. Let's watch this. Oh.
30, 40, 55. After Christmas and after baby's having fun. Today, you have to do
As you can see, we are standing here in front of a very beautiful house, which is just beside our boarding cottages and boarding house. So it would make sense to acquire this beautiful house for the Devi School as a boarding house. And we have the possibility to purchase this from the current owners. So that is where we are going to put our target for our fundraising to, is to try to get enough funds to buy this house. It's way too complicated.
No, it's okay. Because we have, there's so many children on the waiting list, and if we can acquire this house, then that will eliminate that problem. Also, there's room for staff to stay, and we have tons of room over at the school, but it's the boarding that we're limited on space. So this is the obstacle that needs to be removed, yeah?
Yes.
that before. Oh yeah, maple syrup.
My job in the dorm is to wake them up, feed them, make sure that they're showering, cleaning themselves, but predominantly to make sure that they're emotionally okay and happy at the school, to give them love and affection and cuddles and that kind of thing. Also the meditations at the hostel, so we try to, you know, encourage the kids to clear themselves out, to use Sahaja techniques when they're feeling sad or when they have a tummy ache or when they have a headache. And like that, the whole, well, the teachings of Shri Mataji go quite naturally into the daily life here. And the kids resort to taking an ice pack when they're feeling jittery and to asking to be candled if they're sad. And so, yeah. It's a little bit the mother role, in a way, or the role of the older sister for the older kids, because some of the boys and some of the girls here are already 15, 16 years old. I think my biggest lesson here is how giving love is much more rewarding even than receiving it, and they love unconditionally, and even when you scold them and when you tell them that something that they're doing is not right, their spirit can really feel that if you're centered and you're within the Mariyadas of your own role, that you know, they respect you for it, and they learn from it also. And they love you for it, even when you're, you know, when you have to kind of push the disciplinary side of things. Yeah, it's wonderful. It's wonderful to work with this age group, especially for me.
Oh my God!
Being a Dormanti has really changed my whole perspective on how I see the age group of 13 years old, and it's really opened my heart to all of them, and it's going to be a real shame when I go back home and have to let them go back to their real parents. yeah, there's been loads of different experiences that I've had here where I've gained a new sense of feeling a little bit motherly towards the kids that I never had before. When it's just making sure they have a good night's sleep, or even just making sure they're fed, and always like going towards them and being like, "Have you eaten? Have you had enough to drink?" It's a really, really special experience putting the girls to bed at night as well, because they really open up to you during those late times when you're in the dorm, and you can really offer your own personal advice that you usually wouldn't think anyone would want to hear, and suddenly you have these little angels looking at you and being like really taking in everything that you're saying and really understanding everything you're saying as well. It was really amazing seeing the friendships between the kids slowly grow in the dorms, from them not really knowing each other or understanding each other's different cultures and backgrounds, to suddenly realizing that they had a lot in common, or slowly getting to know each other and understand each other in a really like brotherly and sisterly way. And especially in the girls' dorms, you really see that sisterly bond like form over time as they get more comfortable with each other, start laughing in the night, and even times when you feel like you really need to be strict, all of a sudden your heart just softens and you can't tell them off because they're having such a good time and experiencing so many amazing memories together. And you just know that when they're older, they're gonna look back at that moment and you were there to actually appreciate it and see it all form together. And they're gonna remember it and be like, Auntie Sita was my dorm auntie, and
that's the one.
Oh my God, the fly there!
I give it back to you.
Hello, my name is Rohit. The kids call me Uncle Rohit because I'm the dorm uncle here at Devi School. I've been here for almost a year. Actually, my initial plan was to only come for 3 months, but after I left for the Christmas break, I just felt so much joy and love from everybody that I had to come back for the full term. My experience as the dorm uncle has just been simply amazing. You know, day in and day out, I get to, you know, be with the kids and experience how much love they give to everyone, how much love they have within themselves. And it's really nice to see how much they have grown since the first day I was here and since the first day they were here. And see how much they've grown in their meditations in Sahaja Yoga, and also, you know, themselves and how they look at the world and how they look at Sahaja Yoga and other people. One of the most coolest things about Devi School for me personally is just the vibrations here. You know, since day one, it's just been almost every meditation for me is like, it's almost puja level vibrations. And to be able to say that, to be able to experience that, is just such a blessing, you know, to do work for the divine as you're meant to be doing. And it's just a blessing to be able to do that and, you know, and experience that.
Teacher and storycraft teacher at the Devi School. I also do private instruction here in the studio. The kids are great. Some of the kids aren't so interested in visual art. Some of them are interested, but maybe don't have that much knowledge or experience. And then there's a couple that are quite keen. So there's a variety. All the kids seem to have enthusiasm for creativity in general. I've taught a lot of kids, Sahaj school and in whatever, ordinary kids, and it's a different with the realized souls. It's more spontaneous, it's more creative.
This is a ball.
A what?
A ball.
A what?
A ball.
Oh, a ball.
This is a ball.
A what?
A ball.
A what?
A ball.
Oh, a ball.
This is a brush.
A what?
A brush.
A what?
A brush.
Oh, a brush.
This is a ball.
A what?
A brush.
A what?
A brush.
Oh, a brush.
This is a ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
Oh, a ruler.
This is a
ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
Oh, a brush.
This is a ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
A what?
A ruler.
Oh, a brush.
This is a brush.
A what?
A brush.
A what?
A brush.
Is there any downside to working at the Devi School? Is there any at all?
No.
This is the best. This is the best place. The best place where I have ever been.
The McDonald's closes
so
at
12. So much joy, so much love.
Then we have the Great Northern War, yeah, with Sweden, that was a very powerful empire at the time.
I'm teaching senior history, which encompasses the rule of Peter the Great through Catherine, Alexander II, and finally onto Nicholas II, who was the last Tsar of Russia, and how the empire fell, and onto the Russian Revolution.
The school gives a lot of opportunity for music, a lot more than I had at home, and I've learned a lot, and our music teacher is really great. And I'd say that's one of my favorite parts, but I think the best is the bonds that you get with the students. Like, I'm closer to the girls in my dorm than I think anyone I've ever been with in my entire life. And it's crazy how relatable it is and how reliable you can be on them and how trustworthy they are. And you feel like you can trust them with your life. It's like, I don't know, it's like they're actually your brother or your sister, but you don't have to fight with them.
And the collectivity and like how everyone respects you for the way you are.
Well, I like the surrounding and the nature, and also it's quite fun to go to different places, not just always staying in one place, and it's just fun living with everyone here.
My favorite class is history, because I would like to be an archaeologist.
I'm the best behaved one, actually. Yeah, very, very well behaved.
I'm here because it's, first of all, a new school in Canada, and I love snow, and Canada is maybe the best place to enjoy the nature and your surroundings. And then, of course, it's a sad school, and I find it very important for a spiritual life and that kind of stuff, yeah.
I also like, well, the nice aunties that are here and uncles.
Who is your favorite auntie?
Auntie Maha.
Why?
Because she's really nice to me.
To talk about that, how a normal day look like. We are usually getting up at 6:30 in the morning or 6 o'clock, and the meditation is at 7 o'clock. You have to know that all the day is scheduled in the Devi School for the kids. It's very good because there are like boundaries, and between the boundaries, the kids can enjoy everything and also the stuff. We have a lot of joy here, but also we have rules that we have to keep. And in the morning at 7 o'clock, usually there is meditation. Some people who is on the breakfast schedule doing the breakfast, and after the meditation, we have usually breakfast at about 7:30. After that, the kids usually going to the school, walking to the school. We try to make attention that the kids every day doing futsok, because you know it's very important for them. And in the afternoon, there are usually, if it's a normal school day, there are sport activities. So it means that it is part and parcel of the PE, and they are going doing badminton, volleyball, or something like that. It is depends on the schedule. And after that, usually before the dinner, there is some chill time, We can talk about what happened in the school, or just having fun with each other. If the weather is good, we can spontaneously playing soccer or just playing some games. So it's very good. And after that, 6:30 is the dinner time. And after dinner, for every day, all the kids are scheduled for dish cleanup. So there are some kids who has to do the dish cleanup. And after that, we have collective evening meditation. It's very important. And we usually, the morning and the evening meditation is half an hour long.
So I think overall, the main thing with the Devi School, what lies beneath everything and above everything, we could say, is love. Because that's actually what keeps us together at the end of the day. You know, that's how we start, and that's what gets us through. And when the kids go to bed at night, and the staff goes to bed, and all of us, that we lay down and we feel happy that we're together, because there's love between the students and the adults. And you know, we say among the teachers and with the dorm staff especially, that we keep it real, you know? That we keep it real. Thank you.